Aye.
I got pimped. Want a promise or what?
Ben and Pepper will wonder where I am.
I thought it was daughters who were supposed to sneak home so Mother wouldn't find out. Feeling guilty?
I know it's silly, but...
Enough said. Can I see you again tonight?
I want all those tins up there washed out. They could come in very useful.
What the hell for?
You're going to start brewing the grog.
Yep.
You're kidding.
Nope.
Right here under the screws' noses.
Too right. Uh-oh, girls, get on the gas masks.
Ha ha, very funny.
What about her? I mean, if she tweaks, she'll make sure the screws find out.
Well, you two load the tins into the skip. I'll keep her busy.
When do you start work?
Well, I've already spoken to the minister and he's happy for me to start straight away.
Today?
Why not?
You know, that really is good news.
Yeah, well, I don't think Moran's too pleased about it.
Oh, no, no, I hadn't thought of that. Still, I expect he'll be transferred to another prison. He might even get a governorship somewhere else. You know, I'll be sorry to see him go. He's quite nice once you get to know him.
Well, then you'll be pleased to know that he isn't going anywhere.
Oh, come on, Meg. He wouldn't be satisfied being demoted from governor just to an ordinary officer.
What about deputy governor?
But you are deputy governor?
Was.
But they can't do
I'm
that.
I'm afraid they just did. It's true then?
Yes, she's coming in today. The minister rang me.
No, I meant about me.
I'll be staying on as deputy governor, I'm sorry.
Might have known a man would take preference.
Not strictly true.
Sorry.
Not easy for me either. I was enjoying this job.
Well, so did I. For many years.
I know you must feel as if you've been demoted.
Well, haven't I?
You know the public service. There's no criticism of you or your work.
No? Well, it seems like that to me.
If you feel that strongly about it, there's always the Board of Appeal. Or you can talk to the minister. He's coming in to discuss the situation.
You wouldn't mind?
I never begrudge anybody standing up for themselves.
If the decision has already been made, then why is Dwyer coming in to talk about it?
Search me. Got something on his mind. Any ideas? You know him better than I do.
Who knows? He's always playing some sort of political game.
Meg, if you do appeal and the decision goes against you, I hope it's not going to affect our working relationship.
Of course not.
Good.
How's it going?
Look, I don't know. Are you sure this is going to work?
Of course it's going to work.
Hey, what about the top door? You can't leave it gaping. Everything will slosh you in.
Who invited you anyway?
Hey, we could use Velcro.
She's not just a face. Go to it, Legs.
You get too much orange juice in here when you're going to walk your big chested.
Oh, no worries. I'll leave the shirt hanging out. The screws will have a fit if I suddenly had boobs as big as my vest.
All right, so what's the big joke?
You, Kelly.
As soon as you've finished that, you can clean out the inside of the drawer.
Is anyone else going to work today, or are you all just going to play games?
Forget what we're doing.
Get the message?
Give us a boob tube. Try it on for a
bit. Okay, yeah, we'll be careful with the pin.
Okay, then.
What are you doing?
Nothing. I'm just cleaning them out to store things in.
What things?
Oh, you know, stuff.
What's up? Scared I'll blab to Lou.
Yeah, well, wouldn't you?
Not anymore, you bitch. Well, I mean it, Chook. How do you think I feel? No one will have anything to do with me, not even me old mates.
Look, if you want to help, you can go and keep knit.
Well, I could do better than that. This is supposed to be a secret. You've got problems. Well, I mean, how do you think I found you here? Look.
Oh, no. How far's it gone?
All the way down the corridor.
What if a screw sees it?
Oh, I'll fix it. No worries.
I might have known it'd be you, Jenkins. What is all this mess?
Oh, it's detergent, Miss
Ferguson. Who put it there?
I did, Miss Ferguson.
Would you mind telling me why?
Oh, for cleaning. Well, it's this new idea I came up with. You see, I put the detergent all the way along first, then I go back and clean it up. Good, eh?
It's stupid, Jenkins. Now stop your fooling around and get it cleaned up.
Yes, Miss Ferguson.
Come in.
Mr. Dwyer.
Thank you, Mrs. Barry. Good morning.
Nice to see you, Bob. I wish the circumstances could have been a little happier.
Luck of the game. I always knew Mrs. Reynolds could be coming back.
Yes, that was the arrangement. But if I had my way, you'd still be governor of Wentworth. Made a damn fine fist of the job, especially for the riot. And as you see, my hands are tied.
I'm disappointed I won't still be in the seat, but I've heard nothing but praise for the way Mrs. Reynolds ran things.
I don't get me wrong. She's a fine woman. She was a good governor. But you've made some changes here, good ones, and she may not find them to her liking.
Then it's her right to change them back again.
Indeed. Just between ourselves, she's clearly going through some emotional problems. Women of her age can be unpredictable, shall we say.
Can they?
In fact, it wouldn't surprise me if she... well, if there was another emotional crack-up, especially if things got too difficult here. And a deputy governor who has his own way of doing things could add to the difficulties. It could be to your advantage in the service.
If I think her decision's wrong, I'll say so. But one of the reasons I enjoyed working here is because I had the complete loyalty of my staff, even when they disagreed with me. And that's what Mrs. Reynolds will get from me.
Of course, I didn't mean... though I thought you were a little more ambitious.
Ambition is one thing, loyalty is another. As far as I'm concerned, she's boss now. And what she says goes.
Mabel's not coming till after lunch.
You mean you did all that pushing and shoving for nothing?
Well, does you good. Look at Kelly.
There you go. I hope it holds.
Hey, that's really good. Lex, good on you. And watch it. You're in danger of cracking a smile.
What's up, love?
I tread on your toes.
Oh, no, look, it's just Mabel.
Well, what's Mabel done?
It's not what she's done. It's what you're bloody well going to get her to do. Don't you see it's a waste of time?
No.
You're bloody stupid. I mean, no one's going to catch Bassinger, and I'm going to rot in here for trying.
No, you won't. Not if I've got anything to do with it. We'll get the evidence we need, and we'll make them believe it.
You're a real pal, Jess.
You better believe it. Once Jess puts her mind to something, hey. I don't reckon...
Hey, guess what?
It's all Steve.
No, I nearly got caught with the cans.
Well, it's true.
What happened? Well, I leaked the detergent. Lurch covered for me with the freak.
Oh, bull.
It's true. I heard it all myself.
Maybe we've been a bit tough on her.
Yeah.
Come off it, she'd suck up to any flavour of the month. You're giving me the irrits, Kelly. You've got a lot more to answer for in Lurch. And me and Julia still got the bruises to prove it. So you better keep your mouth shut. Unless you want to find bruises in places you didn't know existed.
I say we do it anyhow.
No, I got better things to do. Where are those cans, Chucky?
In there. Reed, I really think that Lurch deserves a go.
Yeah, I reckon so.
Starting to sound just like Nancy.
Yeah, well, she covered for me with the fruit.
Yeah, she did. And I mean, she hasn't been too bad.
Oh, all right. You can start talking to her again. But it's just a trial. One step out of line and...
And what?
She said to say hello to everyone and she'll see us all this afternoon.
Didn't waste any time, did she?
Oh, I'm so glad. Place hasn't been the same without her.
Come on, that's a bit tactless, isn't it? Her coming back has caused Mrs. Morris to be demoted.
Oh, Meg, I'm sorry.
Oh, don't be silly. I'm sure the department has its reasons.
Yes, all provided by one Robert Moran.
He isn't like that, Joan.
Oh, get out. He'd walk over anyone to get what he wants.
Look, I know you don't like him, but I think he's genuine.
I hope you'll reconsider your attitude, Bob.
I won't. And I don't think this is the proper place to discuss it. I think Mrs. Morris wants to have a word with you. She'll sign you out. Goodbye.
I hope this won't take long.
Oh, no, sir. I would like you, well, the department, to reconsider the matter of deputy.
Why?
Well, I have nothing personal against Mr. Moran, but I've been deputy for a long time, and I've also been acting governor. Now, with Mrs. Reynolds coming back, I think I should stay on as deputy.
You have every right to put your objections in writing, of course. They'll be duly considered. But may I remind you, the department doesn't make its decisions lightly, Mrs. Morris, and we have very good reasons for the present arrangement of staff. Now, if you'll excuse me.
He didn't even listen.
Looks like Moran's got him wound round his little finger.
Well, they didn't seem that friendly to me. Front.
Moran's too clever. Wouldn't want us watching him lick Dwyer's boots, would he?
Oh, shut up, Joan. If Dwyer wants my objections in writing, he'll get it. The whole damn list.
Oh, stealer, robbery. You can't get anything under $15 a head, and then it's only meat pies and savouries. So I'm going to cook it all myself.
What, the whole wedding breakfast?
Well, it's worth it. We can put what we save into the house.
Well, where are you going to find the time? You've got a wedding to go to, remember?
No, I wouldn't miss it for anything. Now, I'll do most of it before. And let me see now. Prawn cocktails, beef burgundy, pavlova for afters. Uh-huh. The secret of a great chef is preparation.
Hello, Julie.
Hi.
Oh, hello, Julie, love. You're looking a lot better.
Yeah. Oh, I feel much better, thanks.
Well, still, take it easy, OK?
Yeah, I will. I just came to get the stuff.
Mm-hmm. Lovely girl. Mm. By the way, who are you bringing to the wedding?
Oh, Hope said she'd come with me. We went for a spin down the coast in a new sports car. Found a great place for dinner, a little restaurant by the sea. You should take Joyce there. It's really romantic. Candlelight, soft music, and the food is great.
Well, that's a change. Usually one thing or the other.
Julie.
Steve, by the way, I forgot to tell you that the sink's blocked up. Could you have a look at it while you're here?
There you are. You wouldn't even know it was there.
Hey, you better make sure you don't put too much in. It'll bust.
Well, if that happens, cross your legs and tell the screws you couldn't make it.
You were deaf. Didn't you hear the bell?
Oh, is that what it was?
The smart remarks, Wyndham. Okay, out. What's a fuss, Kelly? You haven't finished yet. Pick him up.
Why should I? You did it on purpose.
Did anyone see me do that? See, Kelly, you can't get out of it as easy as that. Okay, get out, the lot of you. Come on, get to work, Kelly. You could always make a complaint to the governor. And, of course, if you can't hack it around here, I suppose I could try to talk the governor around. There's always Blackmore and my friend Cynthia. She'd just love to look after you for a while.
I don't like it, Rita, leaving you alone with the freak. She might blab about us making the grog.
She doesn't know we're doing it.
Well, she'd have to be blind, Freddy, not to put two and two together.
Yeah, probably right. No, she wouldn't lag. It'd be more than a life's worth.
Well, I don't know. I mean, the way Lou feels about us now, she might reckon having the freak on her side, lesser of two evils.
You worry too much. I'll catch you later, OK? Hey, Lurch! Inside.
Oh.
I said inside!
Yeah, but I didn't do nothing, Rita, honest.
Oh, come on, Rita. Hasn't she been punished enough?
OK, Nance, we're looking at a hero. A chookie told us what she'd done about the detergent. That was quick thinking, Lurch. Got us out of a lot of trouble. So we're going to give you another go.
Oh, you mean it's all right? You're all going to talk to me again?
Yeah, that's if anyone can think of anything to say to you. Oh. But it's just to see how you go. One step out of line, you're straight back in the doghouse for keeps.
Oh, I won't do nothing wrong, Reed. I swear it. And I won't forget how you stood by me, Nance. You've been a real friend. Best I ever had, I reckon.
Thank you, Alice. Now, you'd better get rid of that mop and bucket or you'll miss lunch.
Yeah, well, thanks again. You too, Reed.
Just don't forget what I said.
No, no worries. Oh.
It was very nice of you to do that.
It was a joint decision. I suppose you're going to say I told you so now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I might.
I can't work you out, you know. You're the biggest softie I ever met. Take on any lame dog, wouldn't you? Beats me how you ever had the guts to do your old man in.
No. No, it wasn't easy.
Quite the little canary, ain't we, Lurch? Sing a nice song to the new top dog, did you? Get yourself off the hook?
In a way.
Oh, look, the minute your back's turned, they're going to be throwing knives at it.
How come you trust them and you don't trust me? We've been mates a long time, Lurch.
So what? A lot of good it did me.
Oh, come on, we had a few laughs and we made a good team. We still could if, Look, they're up to something. And seeing as you're in with them now, you could find out what it is.
Forget it.
Oh, no, nothing heavy. Just a bit of fun.
Like what?
Like grog.
I reckon they're setting up to make the stuff. So we let them and then we nick it for ourselves.
They'll thump you, stupid.
No bloody way. They tried, I'd put them into the screws for making the stuff.
You know what your trouble is, Lou? You don't know what real friends are like. You're too busy working out ways to use people. Well, you can stick it, because I've had it up to here.
Oh, go stuff it, Dumbo. You want to go along with them? Well, you'll get it.
Just like the rest of them. You're all hot air, Lou.
No, I'm stupid, thinking he'd ever see anything in me.
Oh, Chucky, will you stop it? He probably knows lots of girls.
Yeah, well, this one must be really special. I mean, Merv knew her name and everything. I felt like I'd been practically throwing myself at him.
You wouldn't know how.
It's probably why he started talking about her while I was there, just to make sure I knew there was no chance.
I reckon he's a bit of a punce anyway.
He is not. He's got real manners. I'm the idiot, thinking he'd ever be interested in me.
Come on, girls. Time for tucker.
Someone's lost her appetite.
Oh, Julie, what's the matter?
Steve. Oh, come on, Jules. He's just a wimp anyway.
He is not.
Can't tell her. She reckons he's got class.
Well, okay, so he's a classy wimp. But there's no point in breaking your heart over a guy going flash his family jewels in a mag. Sheila does that. They reckon she's a tart.
Oh, yeah. Don't, Rita. She's very upset.
Yeah, I know. We all need a bit of cheering up, and there's nothing like grog for that, eh?
So come on, girls. It's Operation Moonshine.
Yeah, come on, Chook. Grog's better than blokes any day.
Thank you. No one's whistled at me for years. It's not like that.
Then it's about time somebody did. You look terrific.
Not half bad yourself.
I'll have you talking like a proper biker yet. You, off to work.
Yes. How did you know?
Just been round to Eddie's. She thinks you're off your rocker going back into the enemy camp.
I know, she told me. Oh, Dan, I hope I've done the right thing.
Of course you have. Here. To celebrate.
It's lovely, thank you, but...
But what?
You, dressed like that, holding a rose, makes you look so different. So gentle.
I'm a very gentle man.
Yes, you are. It's all right, Ben and Pip aren't here. Even if they were, I wouldn't give a damn.
Meg, are you sure you want to go through all this waltzing business with me again?
Of course. Honestly, you're not as bad as you think you are. You just need practice.
There's plenty of it from what I saw. Oh, what's this?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'd forgotten I put it there. I didn't think I'd be seeing you this afternoon.
Meg?
Yes. Mervyn and I would like you to come to our wedding.
Oh, thank you, Mrs. Barry. That's very kind of you.
It's a pleasure.
Come along, Joyce. I think we ought to go to the dining room.
Right.
Seem quite touched by that invitation.
Oh, you know, I feel awful. I didn't want to invite her. We could hardly invite all the rest of the staff and leave her out.
Well, maybe she won't accept.
That's what Mervyn said, but I have a terrible feeling she will. Oh.
Have any luck with the minister?
Like talking to a brick wall. But I'm going to appeal against the decision.
Understandable. I'd do the same in your position. Excuse me.
Oh, I feel so sorry for him. For both of you, really. Oh, it's a dreadful mess, isn't it, Meg?
Will there be a spare locker?
Try the in one.
Kip?
Must be a bit of a shock to the system, being back in the real world.
I'm sure I'll get used to it.
An even bigger shock if Mrs. Morris wins her appeal against you.
We'll cross that bridge when we come to it, won't we?
Hope you can swim, Moran.
Oh, by the way, that newspaper article. One of the officers criticizing me to the press. We never did find out who that was, did we?
No, we didn't. But you could always take it up with the governor.
I could give you a lift, you know.
Couldn't I need a crash helmet?
Oh, I didn't bring me spare. I knew I'd forgotten something.
This won't make any difference to us, will it? By going back to Wentworth.
No, of course not. But I do have one favour to ask.
I do it all the time.
Just this once, I promise. It's Slash's funeral this afternoon. I just really appreciate it if you see that Rita's okay.
Of course. I'll do what I can.
And look after Anne Reynolds, too.
Oh, look, stop giggling. You're making a bounce.
don't be silly, Lou. It's got equal eyes. Ain't that as a missing in a ticket?
Oh, useless practice.
I don't know why I'm so nervous. It's not as though I've never danced before.
Well, your wedding waltz is fairly important.
Oh, Meg, I had this dreadful nightmare last night. I dreamt I tripped over my frock, fell flat on my face, right in the middle of it.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Come on, hurry up, ladies.
Miss Sim, these veggies, they taste real funny.
Sure there's nothing wrong with them?
Well, you try them and see.
Well, no one else is complaining.
Nice to see you, Mrs. Reynolds. Welcome home.
Thanks, Roger.
Main gate here. Mrs. Reynolds has arrived.
Thanks for letting me know.
I know this isn't an easy situation for you.
My appointment was only as acting governor.
You wouldn't be human if you hadn't had some hope that it might be permanent.
There'll be other governorships in other prisons.
And there's always the possibility that I might change my mind again.
That's your prerogative.
It isn't likely to happen, but I'm sure at least one member of the department must have raised it with you as a possibility.
Some people aren't exactly subtle.
No, they're not.
But if it had been raised, I'd have said that you, as governor, have my total support, whatever decisions you make.
Even if you disagree with them?
Yes. Oh, I'll argue till I'm blue in the face, but I won't try to undermine you.
Thank you. I suspect I'll need your support. I suppose you've heard that when I left, the women were very antagonistic towards me.
Yes, they blame you for the death of an ex-prisoner, don't they?
In a way, they were justified, but then Kelly used their hostility to start a hunger strike.
Kelly has gone from top dog to the doghouse. Connors has it, you know.
My relationship with Connors wasn't easy either. Do they know I'm back?
Well, there's bound to be a few rumours, but I don't think it's general knowledge.
I'd better renounce my presence, then.
You need a bit of time to sort yourself out.
Well, just a few minutes. Meg Morris must be disappointed she's not continuing as deputy.
Yes. In fact, she's appealing against my appointment.
I'm sorry if I've caused you any particular tensions, then.
Nothing we can't handle, amicably. I'll leave you to it, Governor.
Both, sister.
Hey, why don't you just go to the laundry and unload it?
You're a worry, Lurch. How risky would it be to go to the laundry during rec?
Oh, sorry. I didn't think.
Well, you did during lunch, so I'll forgive you this time.
Oh, Alice, you're getting to be a real troubleshooter.
Hey, is Chuck coming?
No, didn't have any more luck than you did.
Poor kid.
Look, I don't know why she doesn't just say up him and forget about it. He's a real nerd anyway.
Well, different from her side of the fence, love.
Oh, Rita.
Don't say it. It's worth it anyway. Now, all we've got to do is get some sugar and yeast in the kitchen, and that's where you come in, Nance.
Me? Why?
Because you'd be the last person Merv would suspect. Look at you. Butter wouldn't melt in your mouth.
Oh, no, I couldn't do anything like that.
Why not? You're in here, aren't you? Can't be all that, Lily, what?
Oh, yes, but stealing.
Well, it's all in a good cause. I'll bet you wouldn't mind a bit of a tipple. Oh. It'll hardly be gin and tonic, but grog all the same.
Oh, well, what would I have to do?
Hello, Lou. Not outside?
Nah.
What you doing?
I'm playing tennis.
What about you?
Yeah, that should do it.
Turn your hand to anything, can you?
I'll give it a try anyway.
Yeah. Look, I'm sorry I bit your head off the other day.
Oh, my fault. Guess it was a touchy subject.
Never fun losing, eh? Especially in here.
What caused the riot?
Oh, a lot of things. Listen, you better get that muck off the wall before the freak comes down on you.
Thanks. Yeah, not that she needs an excuse, though. Oh, g'day, Julie. Why'd you leave the kitchen in such a hurry?
I didn't.
Oh, what did I say?
I don't know. I think she's a bit upset about something you said before.
Me? Oh, look, we'll chat another time. I'll see what's wrong, OK?
Yeah, sure.
Hi. Is everything all right?
Yeah, of course.
Come on, mate. We're getting on so well, you've gone all cold and defensive again.
I'm allowed to be if I want to.
You see what I mean? Have I said something wrong? Well, I get the feeling I have somehow.
No. What would it matter anyway?
Well, because I thought we were friends, Julie. Put my big foot in it somewhere. I'm really sorry. Hey, don't cry. It'll be all right. Oh, Julie, cry. Now, come on. Blow. Now, listen. For the last couple of days, we've got to know each other really well. Well, at least, I thought we had. Now, you know I like you very much. So, wouldn't it be best if you told me the truth?
I can't. I feel like such an idiot.
Well, it happens to the best of us.
You shouldn't be here. What if a screw comes in?
Look, I'm not going until you tell me.
Well, I was getting to like you. A real lot. And I thought that maybe you like me a bit too.
I do. You know that.
And then when you said you've already got a girlfriend, she's really beautiful and she's got a
what?
Sports car and everything. Well, why would you want to have anything to do with a frump like me?
Oh, you're all upset about nothing. Look, you should have asked me instead of avoiding me.
I couldn't. Now I've got hiccups.
Just hold your breath. Drink some water. It's the best cure there is, okay?
Well, I had no choice. I mean, I had to go up to the room, even though he was with one of my best girls. So I opened the door, walk in, and who do I find but the most successful barrister in Australia cleaning the room, stark naked except for a frilly apron and a feather duster.
No,
oh,
I can't.
Oh,
Christ!
What's
wrong? I've sprung a leg! We've got to get this stuff to the laundry, bloody
quick. Right, everybody. Oh, Mrs. Reynolds.
What's happening here anyway?
Afternoon, ladies. I wanted to speak to you all to let you know that I've come back to Wentworth as governor. We're all aware of the difficult times we've had in the recent past, but I hope those days are over and we can all look forward to a happier future. Jenkins?
Sorry.
I'm sure Mr. Moran's done an excellent job in my absence, and I'm pleased to say that he'll be staying on as my deputy. There's nothing more to say except that I'd like to talk to some of you individually in the next few days. In fact, we could start that process now. The rec period's almost over. Connors, could you come with me to my office?
Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. Reynolds. I was just on my way to the toot when you came in. I'm really busting.
All right, Mrs. Barry, would you bring her to me in 10 minutes?
Yes, of course.
Thank you, ladies.
Back for you in 10 minutes, Connors.
Right, Mrs. B.
Jeez, I didn't think we were going to get out of that one.
Well, she can't stop a call unless she can.
Funny her coming back all of a sudden.
Do you think she's better than Mr. Moran?
We'll have to wait and see. Right now, we've got to sort this out. Yeah. Can you give us a hand, Lex?
Yeah, of course. Hey, we've got to cover this up. Oh, here, yeah. Quick. Okay. Take this.
Ja, wish us luck, girls.
Jesse, was that true about the barrister?
Is a frog waterproof?
I couldn't understand it. They're usually so vocal. I think if they'd started throwing rocks at me, I'd have been able to cope better.
At least Jenkins stayed true to form.
That was a considerable relief, believe me. Otherwise, that awful silence.
Connors should be able to explain it, but I'm sure you've got nothing to worry about.
Oh, welcome back,
Meg. Lovely to see a smiling face. I've just had a very cold reception from H Block.
Oh, I would have thought they'd be thrilled to see you back.
Do you think it could be just an after effect of the riot? Surely they can't still be holding a grudge.
Oh.
better?
Yeah, thanks.
Good. Because now I want you to sit there and don't say anything till you heard me out, okay? Now, first of all, you're not a frump. And I don't have a beautiful girlfriend.
I heard you talk.
Listen. You heard me talking about a girl called Hope, yeah? How she was great fun. We went for a spin in a sports car. We had dinner together. Well, she's my sister.
Honestly? I thought she must have...
You were right. You're being an idiot.
I feel like an even bigger idiot now.
Well, don't. Because I think I'm the one that's been a fool. I should have
explained... Well, what have we got here? Two little lovebirds in their nest.
How's it going?
Nearly there.
Oh, better hurry up or Mrs. B will be out. Check the loot.
No worries.
Hey, what are you going to do now Reno's back? I mean, all them bikies at Pippa's wedding didn't go down too well, did they?
It's up to Reno. She's prepared to forgive and forget, then so am I. She wants to make a song and dance about things. Well, she'll find out I can hold a pretty good tune myself. Yodel, yodel, yodel.
Shut up, will you?
No worries, I'll finish now.
Well, God, thank God for that. I really do need a leak.
And I look like I just had one.
No, here's your shirt.
Oh, all we need now is a bit of sugar and yeast and whack over it in.
Hey, you know, I still can't work out why she came back. I thought she was gone for good.
She's been here too long. Place has got too big a hold on her.
It's a pity.
I was looking forward to dealing with Moran.
Why?
More fun putting it over. Come on, we better go and find Mrs. Barry. Don't want to keep her ladyship waiting.
I know there's bound to be some discord between the two of you over the position of Deputy Governor. And I'm equally aware that it's my return that's created that, so I'll be honest with both of you. I've heard nothing but good reports about the way you ran things here. The department's made its decision, and I'm more than happy to live with that.
Thank you.
But please remember, Meg feels that she has grounds for an appeal, and I'm going to be asked for an opinion. I can only say that as my previous deputy, you were a tower of strength. Beyond that, I won't comment.
You can't be fairer than that.
No, but let's hope it's resolved quickly. It's an awkward situation for all of us.
Yes, but you'll both abide by the department's decision, whatever that happens to be.
Sorry to interrupt, Governor, but there's an urgent problem. I have Egbert and Ryan outside.
Ryan?
Steve Ryan, new handyman.
Yes, very handy indeed. I just caught them both in a compromising situation in Egbert's cell.
I see.
It's hardly surprising. The man's nothing more than a show pony.
Miss Ferguson.
You wouldn't know, Governor, but he posed naked for a magazine centerfold, and the women found out about it. I advised Mr. Moran to get rid of him.
There
then,
was absolutely no reason to, Miss Ferguson.
Rot. The man's got the morals of an alley cat. I told Moran...
That's quite enough, Miss Ferguson. Meg, would you bring them in, please? Let's hear their side of the story.
Yes, of course, then I'll get back to work.
Thanks.
Mrs. Reynolds, we'll see you now.
Mr. Ryan, Miss Ferguson's just laid a serious charge against you. What have you got to say?
It was totally innocent, Mrs.
Reynolds.
Honest,
we were just
I know
talking.
What I saw,
would
Governor.
You let them finish, please, Miss Ferguson.
Are you taking Connors to see the Governor?
Yes, why, a problem?
Best wait and she can get Connors when she's ready.
Trouble, eh? And Reno only just back.
Be quiet. And in future, when you address the Governor, use her proper name.
Got out of bed on the wrong side, did we?
Yes, I did. So keep it up and you'll be on a charge. Now get back to work.
What's the matter? It's not like you to snap like that.
I know. I'm sorry.
This problem of Anne's, is it to do with the Deputy Governor issue?
Oh, no, no. It's Julie Egbert and Steve Ryan.
Why? What's happened?
Joan found them in a cell and claims the worst.
Oh.
It's probably why I'm a bit tense. If I'd still been deputy, I would have been consulted about it. It's made me realise I'm just another officer.
Oh, Meg, you're sure to win your appeal.
Maybe. Well, don't get me wrong, I like Bob. I think he'll be a very good deputy. It's just that I suppose I resent the way it's happened.
Yes, well, I don't blame you. I feel exactly the same myself.
Actually, I think it's Bob who needs the sympathy. I'm sure he feels the same way. And I'd say that Joan will go all out to use the situation to cause all the trouble she can.
Well, of course, she never liked him, did she?
Well, she's not going to use my problem to get rid of Bob. I'll damn well make sure of that.
Well, that's all there was to it. Julie was upset. I was trying to comfort her.
But surely you must have realised how compromising it would look to anyone passing.
No, it never entered my head. Well, Julie's been having a bad reaction to what happened in the riot. I helped her then, and I saw no reason to discontinue if further help was needed.
Mr. Ryan has some medical experience. If it hadn't been for him, Egbert might not have survived her injuries.
I see.
Well, there was nothing sexual about it, and believe me.
There is a far more serious charge, Governor. He left this toolkit lying open in the corridor. It's full of potentially dangerous weapons and a poisonous drain cleaner, which any of the women could have gotten hold of.
Is this true?
Yeah, I'm afraid so. I was worried about Julie. I forgot.
There is only one course of action open, Governor. He has to go.
I have to agree with Miss Ferguson. I did warn him after I saw the centerfold that any further trouble would mean immediate dismissal.
Thank you. Egbert, do you have anything to say?
No. Except it is like Steve said. Miss Ferguson's making it sound wrong.
Very well. All right, Mr. Ryan. I'm letting you off with a warning this time, but if you're found in any potentially compromising situation again, no matter how pure your motives, it will mean instant dismissal.
I understand.
Governor, I must protect...
As it will if you leave your toolbox lying around again. Please take them out, Miss Ferguson.
Oh, thank you, Mrs. Reynolds.
I have the feeling the repercussions of the riot will be with us for a very long time.
Yes. I think you're wrong. You should have sacked him.
Possibly. And I respect your right to disagree, but I've made my decision, Mr. Moran.
Well, your sweet talked your way out of that one, didn't you?
Just told the truth, Miss Ferguson.
I doubt it. It's very obvious what's going on. So I will be watching you two, and I'll catch you. And then we'll see the feathers fly.
Only you could find something dirty in what is simply a warm friendship, Miss Ferguson. Ah. Keep your chin up, Julie. Don't let him get you down.
You get yourself back to work. But watch your step, Egbert. Otherwise, that early parole you're hoping for is going to be dead and buried.
The freak's out to get both of us. She came right out and said
so. Oh, come on, Chook. They're just threats. Forget about
it. No, she meant it. She reckons I'll lose me early parole if I don't watch it.
Well, she's going to catch you doing something wrong first.
Oh, she will. Even if she finds us just talking together, she'll tell Mrs. Reynolds that we were... Oh, you know.
She's just jealous, love. She doesn't like to see anybody having fun.
Yeah, don't worry about it, Jules. I'll stick in a good word for you with the Gov.
Oh, thanks, Rick. Mrs. Reynolds was terrific. Mr. Moran and the freak wanted to have him sacked, and Mrs. Reynolds just told him off, and that was all.
Good honor.
Yeah, I'll say. It's very nice having the old Steve wandering around. Very easy on the arm.
Yeah, I'll second that. A good perv does wonders for the Constitution, especially at my age.
Right, Connors. Governor's ready to see you now.
On me way. Well, let battle commence, eh, girls?
Wish me luck.
Good luck.
All right, ladies, back to work, thank you.
Oh, what really happened? Oh, we just talked, you know. Hey, you know that other girl he was going on
yeah?
about? It's his sister.
Oh, are you kidding?
No, I got it all mixed up.
Well, I bet you felt a bit of an idiot,
oh,
eh?
Oh, I did, but he was real nice about it.
Yeah, yeah, I know. He's in knight and bloody shining armor.
Hey, Kelly, where do you think you're going?
Going to the toot, that's all.
Already? But we just got here.
Yeah, you fit it on your rounds. I'll have no objections.
Come in.
Connors to see you, Mrs. Reynolds.
Thank you, Mrs. Barry. You needn't stay.
Come on, Connors.
So, now you're the new top dog. How does it feel?
Leader of a gang. I'm used to it.
Perhaps you'd like to sit down.
Yeah, why not?
We didn't get off to a very good start when you first came here.
Yeah, it was a bit bumpy, wasn't it? But there's no hard feelings on my part.
Good. Then I'm sure we'll be able to work well together. Now, Nora had a council among the women. Do you
council?
Intend to work
with... Ha! Sewing circle, more like.
Obviously, you don't think it's a good idea.
No. One gang, one leader.
You keep referring to the women as your gang.
Well, that's how it works with me. Always has, and it always will.
So there's a possibility that you could start to see the officers as a rival gang. And that is a situation I will not tolerate. For heaven's sake, Connors, you of all people should know what comes of gang rivalry and warfare.
Yeah, thanks. But I was trying to forget that.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to remind you about your friend. You know it's his funeral today?
Yeah, that's what I've been trying to forget.
If you need a little time to yourself, you could go for a walk in the
grass. Bugger that! What I'd like to do is stop talking about the past and get down to brass tacks. Now, there's a few things the gang aren't too happy about. So perhaps we should start sorting them out.
Hello, Joyce. Toss a snag on the barbie.
Good cheerful. Well, I heard you'd been hauled over the coals.
Oh, I was. Mrs. Reynolds gave me a bit of a ticking off. Well, I deserved it. I mean, leaving the toolbox in the corridor like that.
You don't think anyone suspects anything, do you?
Well, I think Joan does.
The real reason why you wanted the job?
No, don't worry.
I'm sorry, but if anyone finds
Joyce,
out that Mervyn and I knew...
I promised, didn't I?
Yes. Yes, I'm sorry.
Besides, I think I'm the one that should be worried.
Why, what do you mean?
Well, Julie, I don't want her getting in trouble on my account.
Well, why should she?
Well, I think I'm falling for her. And knowing my luck, I'll go and put my big foot in it somewhere along the line.
And there's no TV and radio in the rec room anymore, and worst of all, is the screws wearing battens. It makes them look like little Hitlers.
I'm sure Mr. Moran had very good reasons for introducing that.
Yeah, at the time, but what's the use now? Kelly's been cut off at the knees.
She could still try to challenge you.
I'd sort her out before any screw could get to her.
I'd prefer they were called officers in here.
Yeah, right.
Is that the whole list?
No, there's the gym. We've been talking about it before, and the girls reckon it'd be a goer.
Yes, well, all these requests are worth considering, but I'll have to have them in writing.
What for? Moran didn't need any damn paperwork when he got his changes brought
in. I'm sure he had mountains of it, Rita. We might make the decisions, but we have to justify everything we do to the department.
Yeah, well, where I come from, something needs doing, you do it. It's just a waste of time.
But you're here now, Connors, and I'm here to see that this prison is run as efficiently as possible. To do that, there are certain procedures that have to be followed. You put your requests on paper, they will be carefully considered.
Yeah, well, as long as it's not just a snow job.
I don't work like that. And let me make one thing clear. You and the women will get the respect you earn. And if you try to snow me or my officers, I'll come down on you like a ton of bricks.
Yeah. I reckon you would.
Dreamed we were together. Share